Good morning. My name is Virginia Dignam and I'm a professor of responsible artificial intelligence at the Department of Computing Science at Umeå University in Sweden. Today we are speaking about responsible artificial intelligence. What is it and why should we care about developing and using AI in a responsible way? It is important to start by understanding what is AI and maybe also even more important, what is not AI. There are many definitions of AI. There are some of them are more based on the policy aspects and the impact aspects of it. Other ones are more technical and more or describing AI in a way that defines a scientific field. And indeed, it's important to realize that even though many are seeing AI just as business as usual, just the next step in automation, whereas other ones are seeing AI as a kind of a magical entity, magic in two ways. Magic because it somehow can function as a glass box, is showing us and predicting for us next steps, but magic as well because it seems that it is some kind of entity which. It comes out of nowhere, it comes out of the blue sky, and just happens to us without us having too much of an impact of it. Both of these approaches or these views are, like usual, the reality, it's in the middle, it's somewhere in between. And AI has been seen for many years as the scientific study of intelligent systems, the scientific study of intelligence, trying to understand human intelligence by building systems that are replicating some of the characteristics of human intelligence. But as we will see, human intelligence is much more than what AI systems can do at this moment, and probably much more than what AI systems can do ever. It is important to realize that AI is not just algorithm. It's also not just about machine learning, and it's not just about statistics or data analytics. Of course, AI uses algorithms, but any computer system is an algorithm or uses an algorithm. But also in our daily lives, we use algorithms for many things. Algorithms are not more, not less than recipes or instructions to achieve in a structured way a certain result. So whenever you are baking an apple pie, you are following an algorithm, the recipe of that apple pie. And like we all know, the result of the apple pie is much more than just what the recipe is about. It depends on your own skills, but also depends on the types of ingredients that you are using for apple pie. If you are using the apple pie using organic apples and free-range eggs, you will get another result than when you use margarine and very cheap apples and cheap eggs. So it is the same with AI. It's not just about the algorithm, but it's about who is using the algorithm and what kind of ingredients, what kind of data, what kind of inputs are we giving to these algorithms. I also would like to say that it's important to talk about AI not as a countable word. AI, there is not such thing as an AI or the AI. We also don't talk about a mathematics or a biology. AI is a field of science, is a field of knowledge, and therefore, it cannot be seen as a countable word. But let's see a little bit more about what then is AI? When do we talk about an AI system? In most cases, we talk about AI systems when we are seeing some computational systems which exhibit some degree of autonomy. And by this, I mean the capability to act and to react without directly an instruction from the user. It is also systems which exhibit in somehow are able to adapt to the world, to change and to take into account differences and the dynamicity of the environment. And they are systems which interact with us, interact with the environment, both a virtual or physical environment, but interact with other resources and other entities in those environments. From the perspective of responsible AI, and when we're talking about policies and guidelines for AI, it is very important to realize that these systems don't exist in a vacuum. They are part of a social technical system, including all those people and organizations that use them, develop them, defining the policies and the regulations for them, and in general, coexist with these computational systems. So the AI systems are not alone, the AI applications are not alone. And when we talk about responsibility, we are taking into account this social environment, these organizations and institutions and people which are somehow responsible for the system. And it's also very important to realize that AI, as we have it nowadays, and despite all the successes that we have seen in the last few years, is not intelligence. It is extremely easy to trick AI systems into believing or doing things which are not correct or not real. Even though we all are able to identify a school bus in all of these pictures, it is very easy to trick an image recognition system to start believing that the picture represents something else. And why is this? It is because this AI systems, AI techniques, as we are using them nowadays, are in most cases not able to understand the meaning of what means to be a school bus or to be a dog or to be a cat or whatever else is in those pictures. They are only able to find correlations and patterns, identify patterns in the pictures that they are looking at. Those patterns can be many different things, and in many cases we don't really understand what and how the system is finding a certain type of pattern. That makes the system very powerful because it is able to identify other patterns and other correlations that we as people are not able to do. But it at the same time makes us extremely responsible for using this type of systems because we know that the correlations or the patterns that the system are seeing are not always the patterns that make the most sense. And when, for whatever reason, a stop sign with some stickers on it is being interpreted as a speed limit sign, the responsibility is not with the self-driving car, which is using this software, but it's with us that somehow use or are responsible for the possibility for these systems to be used in our roads. So the responsibility is ours, and is ours because the system itself is not able to understand the meaning of the correlations that it's making. And it's also another issue is the fact that by seeing correlations, we are not yet at all identifying causality and also not able to see abstractions or to abstract from the correlation to a broader interpretation of what is there. So all those aspects are the aspects where we people have to take care of taking the responsibility. So what is responsible AI, and why should we care? I already said a few of these things. The AI systems will increasingly act and decide autonomously in our world. And eventually these systems are going to make better decisions than we people. Better, of course, is the crucial word here. Better how, better why, and better who. So who decides and better for whom. But on the other hand, it is the aim indeed that the systems in one way or another improve over our decisions. Otherwise, it would make no sense to use this type of systems or to develop this type of systems. What the discussion needs to be is about who are we, what are we improving, and for who are we improving, in what way. It's also extremely important to realize that these systems are designed. They are not these magic entities that come out of nowhere and take decisions based on whatever type of unclear background. Now, these systems are designed. They are artifacts. They are tools. They are built for a certain purpose. And because the system is adapting, because the system is acting autonomously, but still in interaction with us, it is extremely important that we make sure that the purpose we put into the system is the purpose that we really want. And the discussion then is about what is this purpose and who are deciding what should the purpose be. And indeed, we have seen AI being used in the last few years for many different types of applications. And in most cases, we can start seeing that next to the opportunities to make things better, to make things more efficient, to make things more uniform, in many cases, these opportunities come with risks. And here in this slide, I'm showing you some of the results from a study we have done for the Dutch police, but also from a study or guidance that we have done recently for UNICEF on providing guidelines for AI for children. And in all these cases, the opportunities that the systems bring for protecting us from certain issues, for providing us with extra capabilities, and for empowering us in one way or another to do things in a more efficient or in a better way or in a more uniform way, come also with some risks. And as long as we are not able to deal with the risks completely computationally, we really do need to take to deal with them in a socio-technical way. Again, we need to deal with these risks from the perspective of the institutions and organizations that are using and developing and deploying these type of systems. So we do need to take the responsibility ourselves. Yes, and then we come, of course, to responsible AI. AI, like we have seen, can potentially do a lot. The question here and the question behind all the movement and the relevance of responsible AI is, should AI be doing it? And then who should be deciding? Which values should be considered? And whose values should be considered? How can we deal with dilemmas between these values? And how can we prioritize values? Because, and therefore, the essential question should be, should we use AI for this application? So every time we are a group or an institution or an organization is planning to use AI for a certain objective, we really need to start by thinking, should we be using AI for this? And who is benefiting from that? And how are we ensuring that the benefits are distributed and available for all that are being affected by the system? So responsible AI is about ensuring that AI systems are aligned with laws. Of course, we don't want not possible or not at all the aim to design systems that are not aligned with law. But it's also about systems that are aligned with ethical principles and human values. But it's also about systems that are reliable, that do what they are supposed to do, that are robust and don't crash, about systems that are beneficial. And again, important to realize for who are the benefits of the system. And above all, is about ensuring that we are able to verify and to certify that the system is indeed following these characteristics. It's lawful, ethical, reliable, and beneficial. Just some cases in which we should start thinking about responsible AI. Chatbots, which is one of the applications very much used for AI systems nowadays, we have to consider the issues of mistaken identity. As we are improving on the voice and image capabilities of the system, how much is that relevant and how much are we providing or creating a possibility for the user to be mistakenly led to believe that it is talking to a person instead of talking to a system, to a bot? And also, how are these systems dealing with the manipulation of human emotions? How are the nudging doing? And how are the systems trying to convince people to change their behavior? And how is this aligned with the desires and the self-determination of the users of the systems? When we talk about automated manufacturing and systems which are increasingly being used to replace or to extend people's jobs in factories or in organizations, The important here from a responsible AI perspective is to think about the balance between efficiency and the jobs, between ensuring that people are trained and educated, not only to use the systems as efficient as possible, but also possibly also train and educated for a different type of jobs once their jobs potentially are replaced by AI systems. Again, the example of the self-driving cars, which comes very much off, it's very much you heard when we're talking about responsible AI and about AI ethics and so on. The question here is about who and how is the responsibility for accidents distributed by the organizations and institutions responsible for allowing and developing the cars? And what are the decisions that the car should be making? What kind of decisions should a self-driving car make? And what does it mean that the car is making a certain decision? Fortunately, there is a lot of work in the last few years from many different organizations all over the world in which principles and guidelines are being developed for ensuring that responsible AI or that AI is being used and developed responsibly. The European Union has come with the guidelines for trustworthy AI. The OECD has come 1 year ago, a bit more than a year ago, with the principles for artificial intelligence. We also have the work, one of the initial works by the IEEE on the guidelines and recommendations for ethically aligned design of autonomous and intelligent systems, but also the G7, the Council of Europe, many other organizations, public and private, also commercial corporations are coming up with this type of guidelines, and many countries are developing strategies for AI. And in all these strategies, we see the concern and the recommendations for dealing with the responsibility, ethics, and legal aspects of AI systems. But these systems are not, or these principles are not principles for the software, or not only for the software, are mostly principles for us that develop it, for us that researches it, for us that use AI, and for us that are developing and thinking about this type of policies and recommendations. If we, and why is all this concern about responsible AI, and why are all these organizations coming up with principles and guidelines to ensure trustworthy, responsible, and ethical AI? We already referred to this at the beginning. It's about this promise that AI has, that it's able to give us or support us making better decisions. And of course, the issue, like I already said, is about better how, better for who, and better when. If we think about which decisions we would like and we are interested in having AI systems making, so which are the decisions that should an AI system be making? Often those type of decisions are not the decisions that the systems are making. It's important to start thinking about which decisions the system should be making. If we think about, again, the example of the self-driving car, and if I ask you about, think about what are the decisions that you expect a self-driving car to make, you will think about, you know, we would like the car to be able to decide on the best route between A and B. We would like probably the car to take into account traffic conditions, taking into account the time of the day, taking into account the speed or the short of the route, but in most cases we don't think about developing self-driving cars to take a decision of where you should go. We expect that the decision about the goal of the travel is a decision that is to be taken by the user. And in some cases, or in most cases, it is possible to build systems that could decide for you what is the best goal for your trip, but these are the type of decisions that we want to keep with users. So it's important to decide and to think about what which decisions should the AI system be making? And are these decisions for me as a single user, or are decisions for a whole group or for a whole society? And what happens when the decisions that are best for me are not the decisions that are best for the group? How can we enable to decide or to take a decision about what should the AI system be doing what is best for me, or should the AI system be doing what is best for the group? And in a sense, this type of questions are questions that we have been dealing with as societies for many years, and are kind of decisions for which we have found solutions, even independently of whether or not the decisions are being taken by an AI system or not. How should the AI system make decisions? How should this type of decisions and the balance between the individual and the collective be taken? We are doing that nowadays in democratic countries by holding democratic elections and then aggregating all the opinions of the whole group of people which is affected by the decision. However, these type of systems are systems who have been designed by us to deal with the aggregation and taking the best decision for all of us, or a decision for all of us with which we can all accept and live with. But a lot of these decisions, as a design system, Natal's AI system, are dependent on the choices that are given to the system, either for the voters in an election system or to the AI system. What kind of choice does the AI system can take? What are the choices there? How are these choices formulated? How much are we involved and caring about the result of the decision? How legitimate the decisions are? And of course, how are we aggregating the decisions? And aggregating in an average, single average, and one person, one vote, leads to a different type of result than when we use electoral colleges, in which we aggregate things at the local level and then in a hierarchical way at many different levels. So all this type of design choices are choices which we deal with in democratic elections, like in the example, but are also choices and issues that we have to consider when designing AI systems. Because the design we make impacts the decisions that the systems can take, which then impacts society, which again then will impact the design being made. So again, how should AI make decisions? It's important also to realize that a decision which is more socially accepted is not always morally acceptable and not always legally allowed. And moreover, this place in this space where each decision lays can vary from time, across time, but also across regions or across contexts. So things which are socially accepted in a certain society are not socially accepted in other societies. Laws vary from country to country, and things which have been accepted or for which we had morally acceptable at some time in the past are nowadays not morally acceptable anymore. And these changes are seen in many different types of examples, and all of us can think about decisions or issues that are not aligned in terms of social, legal, and moral stance. Things like capital punishment can be different legally from one to another country. The way we think about smoking in public, the way we think about animal dealing with animals or eating meat has changed from different countries, different societies, different groups. Things like slavery was acceptable and legal several centuries ago and not anymore. So all those things can change. And it's also important to realize that when trying to maximize and optimize a decision for many different types of values, we cannot have it all at the same time. So we really have to take decisions and to make priorities between which type of values we want to consider. In order to take responsibility, in order to build this type of systems, the systems which are able indeed to behave like we have been discussing, we can look at it from these three different ways. We can look at the process, the way we are developing and using these processes and ensuring that this development and this use is done in a way that takes into account the ethical and the societal implications of AI, also to take into account the role of the social technical system around the AI system. So we look at responsibility in design. Another way to look at it is to look at the behavior of the system, ensure that the behavior of the AI system is aligned with ethical expectations and is somehow can integrate the reasoning abilities to deal with potentially ethical dilemmas. This is what we are talking about, responsibility by design or ethics by design, privacy by design, ensuring that the system itself is aligned with and guaranteed to be aligned with the expectations in a certain ethical values. Finally, we also can look about the responsibility for the design. So the research integrity or the ethical integrity of all the stakeholders. We look at the researchers, the developers, the manufacturers, the users, and how they can ensure that they themselves are acting ethically and responsibly, and do also ensure that we do have the institutions that take care of the regulation and certification of the AI systems, such that we can have some guarantees that the system is indeed done and behaving in the way that we expect. So if we talk about the in-design, so about the processes, it's about designing systems. So we go back to the definition of the software system, the AI system, and taking into account that the social technical system has integrated the principles of responsibility. So if the system is autonomous, we need to have the instruments that ensure responsibility somewhere in the social technical system. So we have to have imposition instruments to ensure responsibility for whatever this autonomous system is doing. At the same time, because the system is able to interact with us, both in a virtual or in a physical environment, it is important to have systems that are able to account for what they are doing, that they are able to explain what they are doing, and that there is somewhere a possibility for the accountability and for dealing with the issues or taking care that someone is accountable for the cases in which the system is not working the way we expect. And because the system is adaptable, because the system can change and can vary their behavior depending on the context and dependent on how much it has learned in the past, we want to have transparency about how these processes are happening, what is happening there, and how can we be confident that this adaptation is not going away or in the wrong direction. It's important also to realize that all this is done given that there are, for all the design of these systems, there are many options and there is not one right choice. There are many choices which can be taken, which partially deal with these aspects, but like we saw just before, it's difficult or it's impossible to guarantee and to prioritize all the values at the same time. So we do have to balance between different choices. So talking about designing systems that are ethical by themselves, so can we build systems which are guaranteed to take responsibility and to be able to take ethical decisions like what we people do? The first thing is about what does it mean for such a system, such an artificial system, to take ethical decisions? Should we want that? Should we want to teach ethics to the system? And if the answer is yes, what do we need for that? I think we looked at that. It's about the decisions that we take. So the decisions that we take matter, but also the results matter. And what is a good result? It's something which is important to define, to understand, and to have a definition and an agreement about what is a good result of the system. Is that a result which is accurate? Is that a result that is fair? Or is that a result that is sustainable? So the decisions that we take, and both in terms of how to build and how to design these systems, but also about what how do we define a good result for the system? All this matters in terms of how the system is going to build and to deal with ethical dilemmas. And those are not just the trolley problems, but are also decisions about how to take out which type of systems do we find acceptable. A system that is extremely accurate but is not explainable, or a system that is less accurate but it's explainable and can provide explanations about what it does. It is also about thinking how much intelligence, how much accuracy can we deal, and how much that costs in terms of computational effort and therefore of energy. Ethical reasoning, if you talk about our own human ethical reasoning, it starts by recognizing that we are dealing with an ethical problem, with an ethical issue. And once we recognize this, then we have to be able to identify what are possible options here and how should we apply ethical principles to these options. And here we all know that there is not one single unique answer, and there is no silver bullet. Depending on the ethical principles that we take, we will take different decisions. We will look at options differently, based in the case that we take a utilitarian view or a rights, human rights view, a justice view, a virtues view, the deontological view. All those ethical principles, ethical rules, lead to a different answer. So just for fun, if philosophers would be designing autonomous cars, and we go back to this always present issue of what is the decision, what decisions should a self-driving car do when it is faced with a situation in which whatever it will do, it will cause harm to someone. How do philosophers, and now I'm taking a very broad and very simplistic view on ethical and ethical theories and ethical principles of ethics in philosophy, but even here we see that we cannot take one of these theories as the base for designing an AI system. So if we would take utilitarian view, like Mill's view, the idea would be that the car should save the most possible life. So we take the utilitarian view, we count or we weigh the different options, and we take that one in which the most for the best, the best for the most is guaranteed. A Kantian car, a car built following the principles of the deontological principles and the principles of following by Immanuel Kant, would probably would look at doesn't look at the results, at the result of the, but through, looks at the potential actions and the, which action should I take, not like in the utilitarian car looking at the results, but looking at actions themselves. And in this case, it would be, you should not handle whenever you know that your handling, that direct handling would hurt someone. So if the car would take the conscious decision to move from the existing direction because in that direction it would hurt someone, but the conscious decision to move to another direction would also hurt someone, then probably the design of this car would be one in which it shouldn't change direction when this explicitly choice of changing direction would hurt someone. And probably a car designed according to Aristotle's virtuous ethics would look at what the most virtuous drivers around would do and would follow the experience or the design of the other the drivers that do it well. But of course, it is not possible to design a car following purely each of these principles, because all of them would lead to decisions which, in one way or another, we would not find acceptable. So our decisions matter. The decisions that we take to interpret values, what does it mean fairness? What does it mean sustainability? What does it mean good? These interpretations matter. And then this defining the norms that this interpretation leads to some norms, to some rules for the behavior of the AI system, which then again need to be concretized in the functionalities of the computational instruments that we are using. So just to give an example, if we consider the value, and of course, ethics and law, they look mostly at the interpretation stage. But when we are looking at the technology, at the design of the AI systems, we have to move down also to the implementation in the functionalities, the technical capabilities of the systems that we are dealing with. So if you talk about the value of fairness, there are many ways to interpret fairness. And these ways, all of them can be defined as being fair, but they are not necessarily leading to the same type of results. So for instance, if we look at define fairness as giving everybody equal resources, we lead to different types of results than when we are defining fairness as giving everybody equal opportunities. And when we are going implementing these ones, we again reach different types of results. And this result, we need also to take into account that the results is not a one-off thing, but really we need to build systems which are able to maintain a definition of fairness for a long time, and for also in environments which change and which adapt and which evolve. So it is important to make explicit which is the definition of fairness that we are taking, and also to make explicit and transparent how have we implemented this definition that we took with based in the techniques and the resources that we had to implement it. And a large part of the transparency that we discuss and that is often discussed with respect to responsible AI, a large part of this transparency is about making these choices, these decisions explicit, being open about which was the definition of fairness that we took and how have we implemented this definition of fairness. The values is what people consider important, what the society consider important. We can evaluate choices evaluate situations based in these values, compare one situation to another with respect to one of these values. In terms of the norms, is about the possible or accepted responses or solutions to implement these values. And these ones are usually measurable. We can compare different approaches in terms of how they meet the value one way or another. But the functionalities are dependent on the resources that we have and are dependent on the context in which we are. And they are implementable. And in order to have an implementable solution, we are taking a very narrow interpretation of the value which we started with. So it's not, and then the evaluation of the value has to be done within, with respect to the context in which we have implemented this value based on the norms or on the responses that we have defined for the interpretation of the value. So we can talk about implementing values, but we have to realize that once we are implementing values, we are taking a very context-dependent and dependent on the resources and the context in which we are, which is a narrow description and definition of the value. So finally, we look at responsibility for the design, the responsibility that we people have for the designs that we create, and our own integrity as designers, as users of these systems. It's about issues of regulation, about issues of certification, standards, and our own conduct. So, like we said before, AI principles are principles for us. And to start with, to give an example of how this works, we talk about trustworthy AI, we talk about responsible AI, we want to be able to guarantee that systems that are developed and used across our societies, across in our world, are guaranteed trustworthy, and they are responsible in the way that they are designed and used. However, it is difficult for most of us, even for those who design and research this type of systems, to, let's say, look at the system and understand whether the system is trustworthy or not. There is a lot of work that needs to be done, and a lot of technical comparisons and evaluations that need to be done, a lot of aspects that to be monitored and measured in order to be able to guarantee that a certain system is trustworthy or not. We have many other systems are also complex to evaluate by looking at them or by people who are not specialists on that system. For instance, if I ask you whether these eggs are free range or not, you probably are not able to say anything about it by just looking at eggs. However, we rely on organizations and agencies that have the expertise about what are the definitions of taken of a free range egg, and measure and evaluate any specific egg and the conditions in which the eggs are produced to determine whether or not they are free range. So we probably need this type of organizations in order to look at the AI systems that are being used by our governments, by institutions, by companies, and provide some type of certification to indicate that the systems are indeed designed according to a set of specifications which we find appropriate. We also, this certification also can say something about how the systems are interpreting the values. So like we just saw, from moving from values to implementation, how those steps have been taken and how transparent those steps are. And also this system, these agencies, these certificates can guarantee that the use of the system is aligned with the values that we expect the system to be aligned with. There is at this moment quite a lot of work on this area about certifying what the systems can be done or not. And it's important to look at that because the benefits of taking a responsible approach to AI is not about talking innovation in one side and ethical approach in the other side, but it's really taking ethics, taking a responsible and trustworthy approach as a stepping stone for innovation, in the same way that taking a fair trade approach to agriculture and to production was a stepping stone for innovation in many areas of production and agriculture. So taking an ethical perspective provides business differentiation. It provides also, like we say, we need these certifications to ensure public acceptance, but then we can see which businesses, which systems are having which type of approach to the which type of solutions and how to certify these solutions. And these principles and this regulation that are desirable for AI can be seen as a drive for transformation to lead to better solutions and at the end to a return on investment, because you know that you are developing systems in a way that are aligned with the principles that users and consumers would like to have. So finally, a concern about the whole developing of AI. There is still, of course, a lack of diversity on AI, but also a lot of organizations are still very much basing their decisions on a more technical or a more basic approach to what can AI systems do for us in terms of speed, in terms of decisions, but not so much yet concerning issues of transparency, for instance, or bias. So we really need to move and to change the way that AI is being developed and the priorities for which we are building and designing these AI systems. So this has been my talk. Just concluding, it's important to realize when we talk about responsible artificial intelligence that the decisions that we take in terms of deciding what is responsible, what is ethical, what is desirable, impacts the way that the designs are done, which then impacts the way that society is taking or using this type of systems. It is also important to realize that AI systems are tools, are artifacts made by people. We set the purpose, so therefore the principles are, AI principles are principles for us, because the AI system can give us answers, but we should be able to ask the right questions, to ask the questions that are concerned with the responsibility, the trustworthiness, the ethics of the system. Thank you very much.